everybody. Atari here, and I've noticed that when I've been working on my Mac lately, I've been getting that spinning beach ball of doom all the time. So instead of panicking...
No, please, I need the help.
Or wishing I'd bought AppleCare...
Why didn't I buy AppleCare?
I decided to take matters into my own hands and upgrade the RAM, which I'm going to show you how to do right now. Just grab your balls, and let's get started. First thing we need to do is grab our Mac and flip it over. As you can see, mine's been through some shit. Once you've flipped it over, locate the screws that are holding the back plate on. There should be about 10 of them. Use a precision screwdriver to remove all the screws. You'll notice that some screws are longer than others, so make sure you remember where each one goes. Carefully lift the back plate off the Mac and expose the innards. Locate the RAM on the logic board. There should be a couple of pins holding it down. Simply grasp the pins, gently pull them back, and the RAM should pop right up. Carefully remove the RAM and dispose of it in an environmentally responsible fashion. Remember, Macs use a special type of RAM, so make sure you get the correct chips for your MacBook. I picked this RAM up at Micro Center for about $60. The Apple website specifies what kind of RAM is compatible with which model MacBooks. There will be a link in the doobly-doo. Place the new RAM into the appropriate slots on the logic board and gently press them into place. Be sure that everything fits nice and snugly. Once you've finished, and the case is still open anyway, you might as well give it a spray with a can of compressed air. Once everything's good and clean, replace the bottom panel and then return all the screws to their rightful position. Flip the computer back over, and you're all finished.
That's all there is to it, people. Now, if you like this video, click here to subscribe to my channel, where you'll get more interesting things in your video feed, or click here to check out my website, where there's lots of cool news and projects and lots of other like hodgepodgey kind of stuff that doesn't really fit on YouTube, but still very interesting nonetheless. So, I'm gonna sit here, and I'm gonna wait for you.